In this video, we're going to finish the absolute value inequalities KutaSoftware Algebra 2 free worksheet, picking up where we left off in the last video with number 19. I need to isolate the absolute value of r minus 2 in order to solve, so I'm going to add 10 to both sides. When I do that, I'll have 9 times the absolute value of r minus 2 is less than negative 73 plus 10, which is negative 63. I'll divide both sides by 9 to isolate the absolute value of r minus 2. So I'll have the absolute value of r minus 2 is less than negative 63 divided by 9, which is negative 7. Since this is a less than inequality, I know that I will be using and. So r minus 2 is less than negative 7, and r minus 2 is greater than positive 7. R minus 2 is less than negative 7, and r minus 2 is greater than 7. When I add 2 to both sides of each inequality, I'll get that r is less than negative 7 plus 2, which is negative 5, and r is greater than 7 plus 2, which is 9. However, it is not possible for r to be less than negative 5 and greater than 9. Therefore, there is no solution in number 19. Let's move on to number 20. In number 20, in order to isolate the absolute value, I'm going to add 9 to both sides. So I'll have 7 times the absolute value of n divided by 3 is less than 12 plus 9, which is 21. Then I'll divide both sides by 7 to get that n divided by 3, the absolute value of that quantity, is less than 3. I have a less than inequality, so I know that n divided by 3 is less than 3 and greater than negative 3. So I'll write this as negative 3 is less than n divided by 3, which is less than positive 3. So I'll multiply all sides by 3. Multiplying the middle by 3, the left by 3, and the right by 3. 3 times negative 3 is negative 9, which is less than 3n divided by 3, which is n, and that is less than 3 times 3, which is 9. Negative 9 is less than n, and n is less than 9. Circling negative 9, not filling it in. Circling positive 9, not filling that in, and shading everything in between. In number 21, I'll start by adding 1 to both sides of my inequality. 2 times the absolute value of 10b plus 7 is greater than 73 plus 1, which is 74. I'll then divide each side by 2. The absolute value of 10b plus 7 is greater than 37. Since I have a greater than, I know that this is an OR compound inequality. So 10b plus 7 is greater than 37, or it's less than negative 37. So I have 10b plus 7 is greater than 37, or 10b plus 7 is less than negative 37. I'll subtract 7 from both sides of this first inequality to get that 10b is greater than 30. Dividing both sides by 10, I get that b is greater than 3. Then, subtracting 7 from both sides of my other inequality, I'll get that 10b is less than negative 37 minus 7, negative 44. Then I'll divide both sides by 10 to get that b is less than negative 44 tenths, which, when I divide both the numerator and the denominator by 2, I get negative 22 fifths. So I have that b is greater than 3, or b is less than negative 22 fifths. Circle 3, not filling that in, but shading everything to the right, and then circling negative 22 fifths, which falls between negative 4 and negative 5, then shading everything to the left. In number 22, I'll start this problem by subtracting 7 from both sides. The absolute value of 6v plus 7 is less than or equal to 60 minus 7, which is 53. Since I have less than or equal to, I know that this is an AND compound inequality. So 6v plus 7 is less than or equal to 53 and greater than or equal to negative 53. So negative 53 is less than or equal to 6v plus 7, which is less than or equal to positive 53. I'll start by subtracting 7 from each side. Negative 53 minus 7 is negative 60. That is less than or equal to 6v, which is less than or equal to 53 minus 7, which is 46. Then I'll divide everything by 6. That'll give me negative 60 divided by 6 is negative 10, is less than or equal to v, which is less than or equal, simplifying 46 divided by 6, dividing the numerator by 2, I'll get 23, dividing the denominator by 2, I'll get 3. So v is less than or equal to 23/3. Now that I have my answer, I'll go ahead and graph. Circling and shading in, negative 10, circling and shading in, 23/3, and then shading everything in between. In number 23, I'm going to start by subtracting 8. I'll get 4 times the absolute value of 6 minus 2a is less than or equal to 16. Then I'll divide both sides by 4 in order to isolate that absolute value. I'll get the absolute value of 6 minus 2a is less than or equal to 16 divided by 4, which is 4. Since this is a less than or equal to inequality, 6 minus 2a is going to be less than or equal to 4 and greater than or equal to negative 4. So negative 4 is less than or equal to 6 minus 2a, which is less than or equal to positive 4. I'll subtract 6 from each side to get negative 10 is less than or equal to negative 2a, which is less than or equal to negative 2. Then I'll divide everything by negative 2. However, remember, since I'm dividing by a negative 2, I have to switch my inequality sign. So negative 10 divided by negative 2 is a positive 5, and that's going to be greater than or equal to a, which is greater than or equal to negative 2 divided by negative 2, which is a positive 1. So I can rewrite this as 1 is less than or equal to a, which is less than or equal to 5. Graphing this, circle the 1, filling that in, circle the 5, filling that in, and shading everything in between. In number 24, I'll start by subtracting 6. I'll get 9 times the absolute value of 3n minus 2 is greater than 51 minus 6, which is 45. Dividing both sides by 9, I'll get that the absolute value of 3n minus 2 is greater than 5. Since this is a greater than inequality, I'll have an OR compound inequality for my absolute value. So I'll have that 3n minus 2 is greater than 5, or 3n minus 2 is less than negative 5. Adding 2 to both sides, I'll get that 3n is greater than 7, and when I divide by 3, I'll get that n is greater than 7/3. Adding 2 to both sides of my other inequality, I'll get that 3n is less than a negative 3. So when I divide by 3, I'll get that n is less than negative 1. So I have n is greater than 7/3, or n is less than negative 1. Circling negative 1, shading everything to the left, and then circling 7/3, and shading everything to the right. Number 25. I'll start by subtracting 3. 4 times the absolute value of 3x plus 7 is going to be greater than or equal to negative 89 minus 3, which is negative 92. Dividing everything by 4, I'll get that the absolute value of 3x plus 7 is greater than or equal to negative 23. Since this is greater than or equal to, I'm going to have an OR compound inequality. So 3x plus 7 is greater than or equal to negative 23, or it's less than or equal to positive 23. Subtracting 7, I'll get that x is greater than or equal to negative 30, and when I divide by 3, I get that x is greater than or equal to negative 10. Subtracting by 7, I'll get that 3x is less than or equal to 23 minus 7, which is 16. Then I'll divide both sides by 3 to get that x is less than or equal to 16 thirds. However, if x is greater than or equal to negative 10, which is off the number line somewhere over here, I'm going to shade everything to the right. And if x is less than or equal to 16 thirds, which is 5 and a third, and I'm shading everything this way, I'm going to wind up shading the entire number line, continuing on in both directions. So my solution for number 25 is all real numbers. No matter what value I plug in for x, this inequality will be true. Meaning 3 plus 4 times the absolute value of 3x plus 7 is always going to be greater than or equal to negative 89. And lastly for this worksheet, number 26. If you found this video helpful, go ahead and click that thumbs up button. While you're at it, go ahead and click the subscribe button as well. Now let's go over number 26. I'll start by adding 3 to both sides. I'll have 9 times the absolute value of 1 plus 8n greater than or equal to 78 plus 3, which is 81. When I divide both sides by 9, I'll get that the absolute value of 1 plus 8n is greater than or equal to 9, since 81 divided by 9 is 9. Since I have greater than or equal to, I know this is going to be an OR compound inequality. So 1 plus 8n is going to be greater than or equal to positive 9, or it's going to be less than or equal to negative 9. So 1 plus 8n is greater than or equal to 9, or 1 plus 8n is less than or equal to negative 9. In my first inequality, I'm going to subtract 1 from both sides to get that 8n is greater than or equal to 8, and when I divide by 8, I'll get that n is greater than or equal to 1. In my second inequality, I'll subtract 1 from both sides to get that 8n is less than or equal to negative 10. When I divide by 8, I'll get that n is less than or equal to negative 10 eighths, which, when simplified, is negative 5 fourths. So n is greater than or equal to 1, or n is less than or equal to negative 5 fourths. Circling 1, filling that in, shading everything to the right, and then circling negative 5 fourths, shading that in, and shading everything to the left. And that is my final answer for the absolute value inequalities KutaSoftware Algebra 2 worksheet. Also, if you're confused or need further clarification on any of the steps that we did in these problems, feel free to leave it in the comment section below.